Hi, welcome to ESP8266, the 1-mini NodeMCU tutorial from Robojax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this tutorial, we're going to measure the temperature using K-Type thermocoupler with MAX6675 and ESP8266, either NodeMCU or D1-mini, and display the temperature on the browser using your Wi-Fi. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. This thermocouple K-type sensor with MAX6675 is one of the famous temperature sensors for industrial application. As you can see, it can go up to 1300 degrees Celsius with the depending on the type that you get. But this, I have introduction video with all the detail and explanation. And I have a lot of other videos related to this with Arduino. But this is the first time that I'm using ESP8266, so we can measure it over Wi-Fi. And either if you use this Lilon D1-mini or this D1-mini, doesn't matter, or the NodeMCU, because it's all ESP8266. The code that I've written will work with all of these, and we will be able to access it over the Wi-Fi, either on the browser or using your mobile phone browser. I'm using Ajax because accessing this will be very easy. So your Wi-Fi needs to be connected to the internet. And I will also provide you a version that works without internet as well. So the choice is yours, and the temperature will be displayed as Celsius, Kelvin, and Fahrenheit. And now let me explain the wiring. We have here on this side ground. Ground is connected to ground of Arduino. The second pin here, because yellow is ground. The second pin is here, 3.3 volts. It can be connected 3.3 to 5 volts. The green, I have connected it here to 5 volts. The last one, connected in order. If you see it here, blue, purple, gray, and they have been connected to pin 4, 3, and 2 accordingly. And if you're connecting it to this, it will be exactly the same. And for this module, I've put all this in order, and I've connected them at the same color. As you can see here, white is first, and yellow is the last one. So in here, yellow is connected to ground, and then green is connected to 3.3 volts, and then blue is to D4, purple is D3, and then white is D2. So I've connected them from D2 to ground, all in order. Now let me explain the code. I've started the example by clicking at File, Examples, and then Examples for Generic ESP8266. And if you scroll down to Web Server and then Advanced Web Server, I've taken it from here and heavily modified it. These lines are defining the pins, so you don't have to remember the actual GPIO number. These are printed directly on the module, so you just connect to these pins. And I've selected from File, I've selected the board, Generic ESP8266 module. So if you select this, this will work fine. And otherwise, if you select different, if you select, for example, D1 Mini, you have to comment this, meaning right-click and commented like that. But right now I'm uncommenting them because they are needed. This is the MAX6675 library. You can get it by clicking a tool, by clicking a sketch, include library, and then manage libraries. Wait for this to complete, and then type MAX6675 and press enter. And as you can see, this is the one, MAX6675 by Adafruit. It shows installed. In your case, this install will be active, so you can click it. In my case, it's already deactivated, which means it is installed. So this is part of that. And here we are defining for clock, for data and cables. Channel select, we are selecting D4, D3, D2, because we have already mapped it, and D4, D3, D2 means 204, but we don't do that because this is directly printed on the board and it will make it easy. And here you can select the unit. From here you can type F, capital F for Fahrenheit, K for Kelvin, and this title, tell if you want to change it, is this title in here. And this title at the lower section is this one. Refresh time is 5000. This is 5 seconds. Every 5 seconds, this is refreshing. Right now it is not connected. If you want to refresh it faster, put smaller value, whatever you need. If you need it very slower, make this larger. This 5000 millisecond means 5 seconds. If you do not select that true here, use Ajax. If you select this to false, you will see a screen something like this, where you can get Fahrenheit, Celsius and Kelvin. But now I'm uploading the Ajax, so you can see it. Now I'm uploading the Ajax version by setting Ajax equal true. Internet, and this file, ajax.google API. So we need to have access to the internet if you are trying to use this one. Now let me refresh the page. So this is Ajax. Now within 5 seconds, because we set this to 5 seconds, it tries to read the temperature for us, and as you can see, it's now 29 degrees. Now let me refresh the page. So this is Ajax. Now within 5 seconds, because we set this to 5 seconds, it tries to read the temperature for us, and as you can see, it's now 29 degrees. And in here you will type your SSID for your Wi-Fi. Pay attention to the uppercase and lowercase, otherwise it will not work. And then enter your Wi-Fi password inside this double quotation. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. The first thing that you need to prepare is your Arduino for ESP8266. I have a separate video explaining that, but here I can tell you quickly. I will provide you the link. Click on File, Preferences, and then Additional Board Managers URL. Click here, and then paste the link that I provided. I will provide you this one, so you copy and paste it here. Once you paste it, you click OK, and then click OK. Now this link will make Arduino to know where to look for the board. Then click on Tools, Board, and then Board Manager. Once you are able to type, type ESP8266. Then you will see this ESP8266 by ESP8266 community. And if you have not installed it, in my case it is installed and there is a remove button. In your case, if you have not installed it, you will see here install button. Click on it and wait until the bar graph finishes and then close. And you have to select your board before using it. Click on Tools, Boards, and here there are tons of other boards, but the one that we are using will be generic ESP8266 module. Select this. And the rest of the settings should be automatic. And then you have to select, of course, the right port. If you don't know what is the port that you are using, on the start menu, right click, go to Device Manager, or any other way that you have, go to Device Manager, and under the port, collapse it, and you will see serial, USB serial. Maybe you will see some different number, but this is a chip for USB, CH340, that's COM11, and that's why I've selected here and the COM 11. Now, for demonstration, first open the serial monitor from here. I've opened it. So you can see this is the serial monitor. And after that, after uploading the code, press this reset button. And if you're using this module, just press this reset button. Or on this one, this reset button. So I'm pressing it and pay attention here. Now it shows the IP address that you can access. This is the IP address that we are going to type on the browser. Or we type this one, Robojax ESP8266. So I'm pressing this and pressing Control C to copy it. Then the most important part is that click on your Wi-Fi networks and make sure that you are connected to the same network as this module. This is connected to Robojax, and as you can see, this is connected to Robojax. Here I'm going to open a new tab and pressing Control V. So this is the screen, and that is the temperature that is reading from here. And here, this is currently I'm at the 192.168.1.100. Also, you can copy this Robojax ESP8266. And then open a tab and paste it, and it will open. So now I'm taking this heat gun and I will apply some heat here. So this is now made with Ajax, and it will update every 5 seconds. So and as you can see, this is the temperature that we are reading now. As the temperature increased, so it's responding very well. And here, now I just opened 192.168.1.100, and here is the temperature that is displaying from this module. And as time passes by, the temperature will be reduced. If I hold it with my hand, I will cool it down. And here is a demonstration with D1 Mini, either this type, doesn't matter. And once I opened the screen, this is now the temperature, and let me apply some heat using the heat gun. And after 5 seconds, when it refreshes, it will show you the temperature, as you can see. And we can change the time, so we can refresh very quickly. And here on 192.168.1.102, also I can see it here. There is no limit for accessing it. You can connect a lot of devices. I don't know specific number, but it should work for a few devices. So the temperature is being reduced slowly. And here on that screen, and as well in here. So each will update at different interval of 5 seconds. Thank you for watching. This was how to display a temperature from K-Type thermocoupler sensor with MAX6675 over the Wi-Fi on the browser. Thank you for watching a tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. This is the power, and this is the charge LED. Once you connect the battery, it will charge. Let me connect this. So I will put it from the bottom so you can see the light, the green light. Now it is charging, and the red shows the power.